Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up, if you're running SQL Server on-premises and looking to move to Azure, we're going to review your best options for assessment and migration. So today I'm joined by database expert and engineering lead Bob Ward. Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics.
Thanks, Jeremy. Great to be here.
So SQL Server is one of the most popular relational databases in use on-premises today. Now, what are you seeing as some of the motivation right now to move to Azure?
You know, Jeremy, it's just the next logical step. Whether you need to increase your capacity, take advantage of built-in high availability and disaster recovery, or reduce your operational costs. You know, in fact, you can bring your existing SQL licenses to the cloud with Azure Hybrid Benefit.
Right, and with that benefit, you can actually bring your on-premises licenses into Azure to save on subscription costs as well. So what are some of the recommended approaches then if you want to actually bring your SQL databases into Azure?
You know, your options fall into three main categories, which really depends on what you're trying to do. On the one hand, you have the option to lift and shift your SQL servers to Azure VMs instead of your own infrastructure. Now here, we manage the infrastructure, you manage the OS and the SQL instance, which of course could contain many databases. This is a really great option if you need to migrate your databases fast or have specific dependencies you need to maintain, such as distributed transactions or running SQL Server databases on Linux.
Right, and we recently did a step-by-step show with Jeff Woolsey on the topic of server migration for the VMs themselves coming into Azure, which you can check out at aka.ms/mechanics/azure-migrate. But with this option, you still have to take care of managing the infrastructure kind of as you moved your SQL Server into Azure.
You know, Jeremy, that's right, but you get a lot of benefits from hosting SQL Server databases in Azure VMs. You know, for example, you get automated updates and backups, and you can take advantage of Azure Storage, which gives you higher availability and performance. Now, the next option, if your application relies on SQL instance level capabilities like cross-database queries and SQL CLR, is to migrate to Azure SQL Managed Instance, which is a fully managed SQL server. And the good news is, with Azure SQL MI, there's almost no code changes, so you have almost near 100% compatibility. Now here, you manage the instances while we'll manage the infrastructure and the operating system. And the final option is Azure SQL Database, which is the best for modern database applications and gives you maximum PaaS-managed capabilities, including serverless for autoscale and hyperscale for your most demanding critical workloads. And here, we're going to manage the infrastructure, the operating system, and the instance while you focus on the database.
Okay, and this really isn't an either-or decision as well. So, for example, you might want to lift and shift your databases into Azure purely for expediency, but you might also decide later to move into managed instances or PaaS databases.
You know, right, we've seen a lot of customers do this. For example, H&R Block is a good customer example. Once the physics of moving your database to Azure is done, it can be easier at that point to reassess your requirements and potentially go down that managed database path.
So what do you need to do then to migrate to a managed instance or to Azure SQL Database?
Well, there are two main tools you can find from Azure Migrate. The first is Data Migration Assistant, or DMA. This helps you migrate by detecting compatibility issues that can impact database functionality in your new version of SQL Server or Azure SQL. And it helps you right-size your deployment for the appropriate Azure service tier. The second is the Data Migration Service itself, or DMS. Now, this tool is going to give you a holistic view of your data state after your initial assessment, and is used for live migration for zero downtime.
All right, but let's make all of this real. So can you show us how you might perform a migration end-to-end?
Sure, definitely let's do that. So I have here a Parts Unlimited application that I want to migrate. It's currently running on Windows Server. It's also accessing a SQL Server database, which is used to manage my orders for all my parts. Now, in fact, I can hop over to the popular tool Management Studio, and you'll see here my Parts Unlimited database on my on-prem SQL 2017 machine that we want to migrate to Azure. And to do that, I'll need to determine if it's ready for migration and make a decision on what path to take. So first, I'm going to use the DMA tool to assess my database. Now, this tool can be downloaded from the Microsoft Download Center for free at aka.ms/dma-download. But here, I've already got my tool downloaded and installed on my desktop. So I'm going to open DMA and create a new assessment. So I'll need to kind of give it a project name so I can save it for later. I'll choose the assessment type, which in this case is database engine. I'll choose the source server type, which we can choose from SQL Server or AWS. And the target server type, in this case, I can choose from all the options I mentioned earlier, but in this case, I'll select managed instance. Here, I'll click create. Now this is going to go inspect the SQL Server instance and database for Azure readiness. We're looking for things like feature parity, compatibility level, and breaking changes. Now, to run this is going to take a few moments, but here is a report that I've already completed that includes all my databases from my instance. I'll click on SQL Server Feature Parity, and this can tell me what I need to know at the instance level, including any migration blockers. Then I'll click into compatibility issues, and I can see tabs for all possible compatibility levels for all databases. And here are two breaking changes for the HR database that may not block my migration, but I should address these post-migration.
Okay, so how should people then think about the compatibility tabs that we just saw?
Jeremy, a compatibility level is very important. It's associated with each database. It allows your application to rely on the behavior of a version of SQL Server associated with that compat level. So when you migrate, we maintain that level. Now you can learn more about dbcompat at aka.ms/dbcompat.
All right, so now you've got your DMA report. It's great if you have a single database that you might want to migrate, but what if you have quite a few different databases? What's the best way then to look at the assessments and kind of do all of that across a larger estate?
Sure. Now I can upload the database assessments to the Azure Migrate service using the Upload to Azure Migrate button for a consolidated view of the results. And by the way, if you have a large number of databases, you can use PowerShell for that. And you can go to aka.ms/DMA PowerShell to learn more. Let me show you how this will look like in Azure Migrate. Here you can see a summary view of databases assessed from my on-premises environment. I can drill into my assessed database instances and see the readiness status of the instance of my SQL Server we just assessed, which is around 88.9% ready. Now I'll drill in further to see the databases and any possible blockers or breaking changes. Here I can see my databases, the size, any blocker that prevents migration to Azure SQL MI, or breaking changes. In my case, I just want to move the parts unlimited DB, which has no blockers or breaking changes, and it's ready to migrate to managed instance. And I'll retain the 140 compat level of my database after migration. This is great because I don't need to worry about any schema or application changes except for a connection string as I migrate to Azure SQL MI.
Okay, so but before we do that, how do I figure out the right compute and storage level for my database in Azure?
Sure. So if you aren't sure what size instance you want to provision to, that's where DMA comes in again. Now it has two steps to do this. It's going to collect performance data and then analyze the data for the optimal target size. Here, I need to navigate to my DMA folder, and we have a PowerShell script that can be used to collect the performance data. Now I've run this script already, and you can see here that it recommends compute and the estimated cost per month. And if I apply my SQL Server license, which we call Azure Hybrid Benefit, it will save me up to 55%, and in my case, it's around 40%. Now, if you provide the Azure subscription, region, and related details you see here in these fields, you'll be able to generate a provisioning script with this button, and you'll use this to provision this managed instance so it's ready to receive your databases.
Okay, so you create the managed instance. Now, what's the next step?
Well, now that I've provisioned my managed instance, you can see it's picked the appropriate pricing tier from what I use in my assessment. I'll want to go into the Database Migration Service, or DMS, and I'll create a new project to migrate my SQL database. Now here, it needs a name. Like before, I'll pick a source type of SQL Server, my target type, which again is managed instance. I'll choose a type of activity, and in this case, I want to choose an online data migration. Now I can just hit Save, then hit Create, and Run. Now this is going to launch a wizard to configure everything needed to start replicating our server data into Azure. Now, first on the source side, I need to provide a source SQL Server instance name. Now I'm gonna use an authentication type. I'll use SQL authentication, then put in a username with sufficient privileges and a password. And in the connection properties, I'll keep the encryption settings and check trust server certificate, and then I'll hit save. Now on the target side, I need to enter an app ID, which is a service principle used by DMS to access resources. I'll need a key with the app ID. I'll choose my subscription, then importantly, select the Azure SQL Managed Instance we generated earlier. I'll put in my username and password and hit save. Now in select databases, I can migrate the entire instance, but I just need to choose my own database for Parts Unlimited within the instance to migrate in my case. In migration settings, I'll add the network share location where the backups are stored.
Okay, I see. So you're actually uploading those backups from a local network share into Azure Storage.
Right. Now, I'll need to provide a Windows account and password the DMS can use to access that network share. I'll need to pick my Azure Storage account, and I'll expand Advanced Settings. In here, I'm going to change the database name so I can kind of do that right here. Then click Save. And I'm going to add an activity name in case I want several of these running. This can be anything I can choose as a name. And at this point, I can run the migration.
Right. And this is probably going to take a while depending on the size of the database and the bandwidth and kind of all the physics involved, right?
Yeah, exactly. But here's what's important. My app and database are still online during all this. That's kind of why we call it an online live migration. Now, to save time, we already have a migration running, which you can see here in DMS. So I'll click into Parts Unlimited. We'll see it's now running. And I can see a sequence of log backups that are all restored. And this process runs continually until you're ready to do that cutover. Now, when you're ready to do the migration cutover, make sure you stop incoming traffic to your database. Then you need to perform a final log backup called a tail of the log backup in Management Studio, kind of like we see here. Then moving back to DMS, we'll see after I hit refresh, it's already uploaded the backup file that I just did, and it's already been restored. Now I can do the migration cutover. I'll need to kind of confirm, I'll hit apply, and once it completes, the database is running in Azure.
All right, so now you've shut down your production service, performed your final kind of Delta backup. It's ready then to take on the production workload. But how does the app then know how to and where to talk to the database now that it's running in Azure?
Yeah, Jeremy, it's one of the great stories about this migration. So once you've migrated your app and one that uses this underlying database using the App Service Migration Assistant, you just have to change the connection string to redirect it to the database in Managed Instance in Azure. So you can go into Edit and Search, open up the App Service Editor here, redirect the connection string of the app to the new Managed Instance name, and boom, now you can see my app is running the cloud and connected to Managed Instance.
So in this case, you actually chose to migrate your SQL database into Azure SQL Managed Instance, but what would that process look like if you had chosen to migrate to Azure SQL Database?
Yeah, Jeremy, great question. You know, the workflow is a little different, but you still get to use the same DMS service migrating SQL Server databases to Azure SQL DB. Now, additionally, you'll first need to apply database schemas before you do the migration. But in fact, we've documented this whole process here at aka.ms/Azure SQL Migrate.
So once you're in Azure, you can also do lots more in terms of performance and security. So for example, in Azure Security Center, you can monitor the health and security posture of your databases, whether they're in VMs or managed instances or PaaS. And this also includes mitigating security threats with advanced threat protection services.
As you go to Azure SQL DB as a native PaaS service, one of the unique things is how you can visualize your query performance and tune your indexing. Now here you can drill in and get recommendations for performance. You know, we use machine learning behind the scenes to look at your indexes and determine the right optimizations for performance. We even have options even to automate this entire process.
Thanks so much for joining us today, Bob, and really going through all of our different migration options for moving your SQL databases into the cloud. Now, if you'd like to learn more, you can also download our Azure Database Migration Guide at datamigration.microsoft.com. And of course, you can check out the rest of our Azure Migration Series at aka.ms/mechanics-azure-migrate. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.